Many women with BRCA1, BRCA2 associated breast cancers can do very well with current treatment. But these can be quite aggressive forms of breast cancer. We want to find smarter, kinder, more targeted treatments that are specific to the kind of BRCA 1 and 2 forms of the disease.
So PARP inhibitors are a class of drug that they, as the name suggests, they inhibit a DNA repair protein known as PARP. And it's a set of drugs that we've been working on for over a decade now. And they cause a particular type of DNA damage that selectively target cells, tumour cells that have defects in the BRCA1 or BRCA2 tumour suppressor genes. I was a postdoc at the time. I was younger, thinner, had more hair. And what we found, and this was, I worked for Alan Ashworth at the time, this was in his lab. And what we found then is that tumour cells, and in some cases breast tumour cells, that had mutations in either BRCA1 or BRCA2 were really very, very sensitive to PARP inhibitors. I think at the time there was a lot of excitement because everyone could see the potential of this approach, but it still needed to be tested.
It was very important to do a trial to assess whether PARP inhibitors were indeed smarter kind of treatments. You need to prove that if you're going to ask a woman to accept a treatment and perhaps not have chemotherapy as an approach. So this trial, Olympiad, compared a PARP inhibitor, olaparib, with the kinds of chemotherapy that oncologists like myself might usually have chosen to treat that woman's advanced breast cancer, and asked the question, was the PARP inhibitor more able to cause the tumour to shrink and, most importantly, delay the progression of that cancer and the requirement for more treatment later on? And the trial showed that indeed it does appear to be better than those standard forms of chemotherapy for this kind of breast cancer. It's also taken a huge effort from researchers, and I'm very proud to say researchers are based at Breast Cancer Now's Research Centre at the Institute of Cancer Research several years ago now, in doing the scientific experiments that proved the concept in the laboratory. And that, for me, has been a wonderful example of how laboratory science, when directed to solve a problem in the clinic, can really make a difference.
Here at the Breast Cancer Now Centre, you know, we're very focused on those very practical, pragmatic issues. As a scientist, one of the things you always dream about doing is doing a piece of lab work that actually, within your career, can make a tangible difference to someone with cancer.
Breast Cancer Now are, you know, a major sponsor of the work that we do here. They are an inspiration. They provide the grant funding that we have to do a good job of explaining why we want to work on these areas, the quality of the science that we do. But if we do that and convince the scientific review panels, then we have funding available to do the science. And we get to work in partnership with a charity utterly committed to improving the lives of women who either are at risk of this disease or sadly develop this disease.
All of the work we did and we're still doing is driven by people that, you know, did moonwalks, ran marathons, cycled across the country. You know, it's as much their work as it is ours. And, you know, if as much as we as scientists have this kind of sense of achievement about what's happened with PARP inhibitors, everybody raised just a penny for Breast Cancer Now should feel that achievement as well.